Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today, we're gonna make a new PowerPoint template and make it accessible. The first thing we're gonna do is launch PowerPoint and select File, New, or when you first launch PowerPoint, I'm gonna select Blank Presentation. Then I'm going to go to the View button and then slide Master. And this is where I'm going to make changes to my master slide deck. One of the things that I personally want to get rid of is the use of the date field and the footer on the bottom. I do, however, like the page number. Also, this is where we can insert a logo or a picture, and I'm just gonna drag that in, and I'm going to move this to the top right corner and make sure to set my alternate text. And I can say the accessibility guy logo. I'm then going to change the color bullets in my document. Let's select all of the text. I'm going to right click, select the bullets drop down, and then select bullets and numbering. Then from here, we can change the color of the actual bullet points themselves. I'm going to choose this darker blue and select OK. Now any bullets throughout my document will look exactly the same. We can also adjust things like the slide title. So if I wanted to make any updates to this, I could simply bold it. I could make the font slightly larger or any other formatting options that you would want to. You can also edit the text throughout the document. In this case, I'm editing the bullets themselves, but I don't mind what I have here now, so I am going to just leave. As I move through this, I do notice that the footer and the date are still in my template, so I'm gonna remove these from every one of these slides. These are the different themes that I have available that I can choose when I'm building my PowerPoint, and there are quite a few. And I doubt that I would need this many templates inside of my template, but I'm just going to leave them for. Next, we can begin to adjust any of the master slides that we want. So the black and white is a little boring, but I do appreciate that it is still accessible. Let's see if we can make this look a little more visual. I'm going to right click the slide and select Format Background, and we can do maybe a gradient fill, and we can choose the different colors we want to apply. You can also do a pattern fill, a solid fill, a picture or texture, and I like very light blues. Let's go even lighter. And you can also change the different colors, the different gradients. Okay, I think instead I'm just going to do a sky blue. Now there's other things we can do, like fill in the page count area. So if I wanted this to be a different blue throughout the whole document, I could do something like that. But I actually want to do that on our main slide here. Let's do this dark blue and carry it all the way through. And then I'm gonna change the font of the page number to be white and bold so that it passes color contrast requirement. And this is a really basic edit that we're doing here, but it can add a little bit of flair to the content. And as I begin creating more PowerPoints, it's gonna be pretty simple for me to come in here and adjust the different areas within the slide design theme. And now if I go to create a new template, a new project, it is mostly functional and accessible. I'm not seeing that blue line, but all right, in order to get my slide numbers to appear on the bottom right, I had to go to Insert, Header and Footer, and select the slide number, and then Apply to All, and that applied it. And then we can put in some dummy information, and there we go. Our content is now accessible inside of this PowerPoint presentation.